In the northwestern mountains of Oaxaca State lies a small town known for their intricate purple fabrics. In Pirotepa de Don Luis, the women weavers of the Tishinda Cooperative have been passing down their traditions for more than 3,000 years. However, these traditions are under threat.
For our latest investigation, we spent several days at the Pueblo and among the weavers' families. Here, we learned about one woman's mission to support this community through a reverse migration project.
My name is Patrice Perilli. I'm an immigrants' rights attorney, and I'm the director and founder of Mexican Dream Weavers, a volunteer profit that supports indigenous weavers in Mexico so that they can weave in their homes instead of cleaning ours. It's a reverse migration project. 15 years ago, there was no tourism in Oaxaca due to a teacher strike. People found out that I was an immigration lawyer, and they asked me if I could help them go to the United States where they would be cleaning homes and offices, and I saw what they did, and it was just amazing to me, and I said, no, I'm going to help you stay right here. Well, there's lots of Oaxacan weavers, but our group, which is from the town of Pinotepa de Don Luis in Oaxaca, are one of the last groups in Mexico that grow their own cotton. They grow white cotton and a native brown cotton called coyuchi. They spin it with a drop spindle, which is pre-wheel. You know, they're just talking about a gourd and a stick with a mud ball on the end. And then they dye it with natural dyes, the red cochinilla that comes from the beetles that live in the nopal cactus. But their real claim to fame is the sacred purple dye that comes from an endangered sea snail called Tishinda in the Mixtec language. And right now there are only 15 men alive on Earth who can still lovingly and sustainably milk this rare sea snail that grows along our rocky coastline to obtain the sacred purple dye, which represents the moon, fertility, and all things feminine in their culture. So it's about 400 hours of women's work that goes into each of our pieces. And the rarer the dye, the more expensive the piece. So if you're talking about something with a lot of our Tishinda purple, some of the pieces are, you know, quite expensive, but they're collector's items. They're in museums, and textile collectors from all over the world have our pieces because they're so rare.
Meeting the weavers for the first time was an exciting experience. On the morning of filming, the women, some in their 70s and 80s, arrived one by one with their work tools in hand. The intricate and time-consuming process begins with the picking of cotton. They then take out the seeds and begin beating the cotton with wooden sticks to break down the fibres. After cleaning and ordering, the women begin to spin the thread using a drop spindle called a malachite.
However, the process is far from over. After the thread is reorganised and dyed, the woven balls are wrapped around the urdimbre. It takes hours for the careful process to take place. That'll determine the colours of the final garment. After it's finally in shape, the thread is added to a backstrap loom and is tied to a pole. The final product can take months to create.
Mi nombre es Amada Sánchez Cruz. Somos una organización del grupo Tishinda.
Es lo que uno se viene en la cabeza pensando. No hay dónde ver, sino que es como un dibujo tradicional. ¿Quién sabe en qué tiempo empezaron a tejer esto?
Es telar de cintura con tintas naturales. Preparar mi hilo en una semana. Y ya, si voy a hacer un blusón, lo voy a trabajar en un mes. Si voy a hacer un huipil, en 2 meses.
¿Te gusta su trabajo?
Me gusta mucho. Sí. Me gusta mucho porque mi familia viene de muchas artesanías.
Protection for the snail. The Tishinda snail is almost extinct. It's an endangered species. It's illegal to harvest it, but it's still happening and there's no enforcement of the law. We're worried that the Tishinda snail will be gone, it will be extinct. Their cultural identity is totally tied to this sacred color. So they revere the snail, they protect it. This is the last group doing it right now. But our biggest concern is keeping the purple dye alive. In old days, 2 sacks of thread they would dye. Now they're lucky if they can get 2 little skeins of thread dyed. So the men who are doing it now in the cooperative of dyers are all 55 to 85 years old. It's very dangerous work. People have died doing it because you have to do it along the coastline. Waves are crashing on you, and it's just really dangerous.
Actualmente nosotros somos el único grupo que estamos autorizado y de todo México para poder hacer este, ordeñar el caracol púrpura. Lo ves, es de madera para no lastimar al caracol. Está pegado así y nada más lo palanqueamos tantito, lo levantamos. Entonces él se siente agredido, entonces suelta la tinta y nosotros lo vamos poniendo sobre el hilo que nosotros tenemos. Y esta tinta es una tinta natural. Y para nosotros el color púrpura es algo muy importante en nuestra cultura. Solamente nosotros los mixtecos podemos ingresar para teñir con el caracol. ¿Por qué? Porque nosotros no lo matamos. Al momento de terminar de ordeñar, lo regresamos a la roca y él continúa su ciclo de vida.
Yo empecé a trabajar en 1956. En ese año caminé 8 días para llegar a Puerto Ángel y hasta ahorita todavía me voy a pintar el hilo porque sí me gustó mucho. Tenía yo 15 años cuando me fui caminando 8 días. Sí hay un poquito, pero ya no hay como antes. La gente se lo comen.
La gente de la zona que van y lo sacan juntamente, sacan el caracol, lo rompen y lo pican y lo echan a una bolsita y lo venden a los restaurantes. Eso, nosotros estamos luchando para que esto no se desaparezca, para que el caracol continúe y nuestra cultura sigue teniendo el mismo valor. Mi papá, él dice, ya perdió la esperanza porque él, cuando él inició, había bastante caracol. Ya vi el bajón y ahorita ya estoy viendo como un 40%, ya va cada año más, va.
¿Y su trabajo es peligroso?
Sí, es peligroso. Se han muerto unos compañeros por allá.
Ajá.
Se han muerto en el agua, caen y mueren. No quieren porque es peligroso y ya no hay caracol.
While saving the purple snail is urgent, the collective also faces other challenges. Although the tradition is sometimes passed down to their daughters, many younger mixtecs aren't interested in this line of work.
Like the snail dyers, it's an art that faces challenges of surviving for the coming generations.
We have 3 young men from the next generation who have come back from New Brunswick, New Jersey, where they've been laying tile and have taken up the dyeing. They've learned it from their fathers and their uncles, and so they're the hope for the future. If they had not started, it would have died with this generation.
Y aparte los de la tinta natural también cuidar las plantas para que, por ejemplo, el cempasúchil, tener que cuidarlo. Pues ayudar a conservar la naturaleza, ayudar a lo del caracol, hay que estar más pendiente de eso para que no se acabe, porque yo siento que en unos 10 años o 15 años tal vez ya no pueda existir.
Podemos convivir con otra especie también de los animales, de no matarlo, de no comerlo, para que la naturaleza... Nosotros estamos destruyendo la naturaleza, los bosques, los sacamos madera, hacemos infinidades de cosas y este es un gran ejemplo cómo debemos de convivir con la naturaleza sin hacerle daño.
It's a question of education, conservation, and we want to pay the dyers to protect the snails. Then they would make a living doing this. They wouldn't just do it for their mothers and their sisters so that they can weave.
Cualquier persona nos pueden apoyar como Patricia, porque sin ella pues nosotros no podemos también hablar, pues nosotros como hablamos mixteco y español, pues nada más eso.
Tengo esperanza de que se pueda reproducir. Sí, de que no hay que matar a los caracoles, no hay que comer, muy importante en la ecología, en la vida marina, es muy importante también en nuestra cultura. Y de aquí en 2 años no hacen nada, pues lamentablemente eso se va a desaparecer.
Es una tinta muy especial y no lo queremos perder porque queremos que nuestras hijas sigan con esa tradición.
Esto hasta actualmente lo seguimos realizando, es parte de nuestra vida, es parte del conocimiento de los mixtecos.